The summer wind came blowing in from across the sea. It lingered there to touch your...
Are you Ben Oddfoot?
Yes. What's this about?
Is this your trophy?
Could be mine. Mine was stolen this afternoon.
Does this look like your hat?
I had one like it. It had blood on it, so I threw it in the trash. You're saying, without a doubt, I can start filming in England 2 weeks from tomorrow.
Not to worry. No fuss. As long as you have lots of dinero, 10 million can buy you a lot of freedom.
The fact that they would let an accused killer out at all goes to show what a joke our criminal justice system has become. Guilty, guilty, guilty.
I dated her sister. A real angel.
I recall you telling me she was a bitch.
She was, when she was alive.
Take a look at Ben in Shakespeare in Love.
What is the play and what is my part?
One moment, sir.
Who are you?
I'm the money.
Then you may remain, so long as you remain silent.
It's a great movie and you're great in it. No, I haven't seen you since the big Oscar win.
After the win, I entered a poker tournament in Las Vegas. Then I was in England for 4 months filming a movie. Now it's back to Las Vegas. My trial starts in 2 weeks.
It can happen from direct blow to the head. Dee died of a brain hemorrhage called an epidural hematoma. Risk factors: chronic, long-term alcoholics.
What, if anything, did Mr. Oddfoot say?
He dreamt of shoving his golden woman down Mr. Huntsucker's throat.
That was a scene from Splitting Nines, a thriller spoiled by Ben Affleck's performance.
I loved Ben in this. He's delightfully creepy. An award-winning performance.
The Razzie Award. If he doesn't win, I'll eat his golden woman. I'm JT.
Hello, I'm Ellie.
More from JT and Ellie after a short break.
I got a golden member he can suck on. Don't let him bother you, Pod. Last night I dreamt I shoved my golden woman down his throat. Hello, Dora.
Wow.
Pardon?
Sorry. Just thinking out loud.
President Monroe, tell the jury what you heard, if anything, on the night in question.
About 1 a.m., I heard a loud thump. I was curious. So I looked out my door. I saw Ben leaving Mr. Huntsucker's room.
Where were you shortly after 11, the night in question?
At a men's club down the street from Binion's Casino.
Who were you with?
Greg Norman at first, and then Mr. Huntsucker.
Mr. Huntsucker was a homosexual, correct?
Not that I'm aware of.
Did you offer to buy Mr. Huntsucker a drink?
Yes.
All in.
I call.
The prettiest two cards in the deck.
I prefer the ladies. They never let me down. And they're great to look at. Look at that smile. Heart-stopping. Woody, how do you get so many young, beautiful women to go out with you?
They know that you're not gonna, you know, do something terrible to them. And they're wrong.
Damn.
Three queens win the pot.
That lucky, egotistical, irrelevant boob.
I got lucky. It happens. Stop by at Jug's tonight, after the tournament. I'll buy you a drink.
Did you and Mr. Hunsicker share a taxi that night?
Yes.
Did you walk him to his door?
I wouldn't say I walked him to his door. His room was across from mine.
Did you enter his room?
Absolutely not.
Before lunch, you testified you found a baseball cap, correct?
Correct. Just above the victim's head.
Officer Bushman, do you use the word Jaime?
No, sir.
Have you used that word in the past 10 years?
Not that I recall, no.
So, anyone who quotes you as using that word would be a liar?
Yes, they would.
All of them?
All of them.
Yes. Mark Bushman said a Jaime is a Jewish person. It was 10 years ago tomorrow. I remember because it was on my birthday.
Ms. Horn, what prompted Detective Bushman to use that word?
We were playing Scrabble. He made that word and said a Jaime is a Jewish person.
Ms. Horn, what made you come forward with this information?
Mark Bushman is a liar and a cheater. I thought the court should know. You can't use slang words in Scrabble. I found out after he won the game by a few points.
You don't think it's possible he made an honest mistake?
No. He wanted sex. He'd lie and cheat for sex. He pressured me into making a bet. I didn't think he had a chance.
Your Honor, permission to approach. I request that Miss Horn's entire testimony be stricken from the record.
Miss Wretched has a problem. Star witness lied under oath.
Star witness? He testified he found a hat at a murder scene.
I want Detective Bushman recalled to the stand, so I can question him about that serious felony.
You can't be serious.
As serious as lying about an intern on her knees.
Your Honor, this foolishness is a waste of the court's time. The detective said a word 10 years ago. So what?
Ms. Wretched, your request is denied. Detective Bushman will be tried for perjury at a later date.
Tomorrow night, I'll prep you for Wretched. She's tough, but the judge is on our side. Before court, get an afro.
An afro?
An afro haircut.
On a personal note, just a herald in Ben's. He's one of the greatest people that I've ever known.
Why bring it to a poker room?
I was going to give it to Debbie Reynolds.
Give what to Debbie Reynolds?
The trophy.
It's about 14 inches.
You must be proud of it.
Of course. Do you want to see it?
That would be totally cool.
Yeah, I'd love to see it too.
It's going on display in Debbie Reynolds' new casino. Debbie's meeting me here later on today.
He didn't win that for acting, that's for sure.
Ben, tell the jury why you threw your hat into the trash can.
It had blood on it.
Sorry about that. Uh-oh, there's some blood on your hat. Sorry about the hat, bud.
It may be fitting, Your Honor, to have Ben try on the hat at issue.
I'm not impressed. This is like a circus, and you're the ringmaster.
If you fill the room with smoke, the jury can't see the evidence.
I didn't kill Hunsicker.
I don't care.
You used to socialize with President Monroe, correct?
Yes.
Do you know of any reason why he would lie about seeing you leave Mr. Hunsicker's room?
I know. Without a doubt, I wasn't in his room. That night or any other night.
How do you think your trophy ended up in JT's room?
I have no idea.
If the jury decides that it was your hat by the body, can you explain to them how it got there?
No.
You assaulted JT Hunsicker out of anger, didn't you?
Absolutely not.
All the evidence clearly proves that you did, Mr. Artflick.
Objection.
Withdrawn. I'm through with this witness. I told Attorney F.U. Daly. Yes, I'm sure it was a gold trophy.
F.U., we have to talk. And bring your number one client with you. You know who I mean. My trial was just a facade. A false front to protect your real client. You killed Hunsicker. It was an accident.
What's in the bag, JT? It looks heavy.
Have a drink in my room. I'll show you.
Why do you pick on Ben, JT?
He said on the Tonight Show, I'd praise Plan 9 from outer space if the price was right.
That looks like Ben's cap.
It is. I'm going to play a little joke on Mr. Oddflick.
What kind of a joke, JT?
I'm going to leave the cap and that at a local brothel.
I don't see any humor in that.
Whatever. Let me fix us a couple of drinks.
This is heavy. The shock showed me a new golf swing. A real monster. What?
Yikes.
That should cover all losses. Plus your normal fee for a movie.
I ought to turn you in.
You won't. There's nothing to gain for anyone except the tabloids. I knew a jury would never convict you. I didn't have a chance.
You owe me. Big time. If I ever need you for a movie I'm making, you better say yes.
Of course. That goes without saying.
Let the healing begin.
10 million. No, not a chance. I'm depicted as a sex fiend, a fool, and a murderer.
You'll be playing a fictitious character.
Tell Harvey I'm sorry, but I can't do it.
20 million.
And 5% of the gross?
We have a deal.